Good morning. Welcome to our talk. In this talk, we speak about the technology and what is the approach about the manufacturing, what is the effort for be responsible. For this, I pose one question to the speakers, and I want to ask how responsible manufacturing have its own value in sustainability. And let's listen to the point of view and experience of some innovative company that approach manufacturing in a responsible way. The first speaker is Andrea Rebonato, marketing and product development from Framis Italia. Andrea speak about thermoadhesive application and how disruptive innovation can change the future of fashion.
Thank you, Loreto, for the question. Thank you, everybody. And well, no, at Framis, we have been discussing about responsible approach to our production process for years. And basically, we start asking ourselves how we can contribute, how we can, tackle this specific subject in the best possible way. And basically, after several debates, the conclusion was that we can't do it alone. We are part of a manufacturing system, a supply chain, and if you want to become really responsible, we need to involve all our partners in this specific goal or in this vision. Framis is a company specialized in solution or disruptive solution for the decoration, the embellishment, and the manufacturing of garment and in general of products without using of stitchings. So no needle, no thread. We are just proposing a thermo-welding solution where offering machines and consumables part, so films and tapes, we are giving our customers, brand, designer, any kind of people involved in the production process, the possibility to create innovative things without stitchings. The consumable part, basically, is made out of chemicals. And that's where we really believe we could give our contribution. We need the help of all our supply chain to be more responsible or to achieve the responsible manufacturing goal. You know, every day we are in contact with chemicals component in any form, from the mobile phone you have in your hand to the seat where you are sitting now to the microphone I'm using in this moment. And therefore, we are living with chemicals for anything in our daily life. From this point of view, our goal was to become more greener and with a different approach, with an approach towards a good chemistry, the way to manage all the chemicals component in the best possible way toward the environment, towards the people who lives and who has to do with our products, and towards all the everything that is going around us. To do this, we decided to implement a protocol that is asking a commitment to all our suppliers, from the raw material to all the components that are used during the production process, in order to maintain the specific requirements, the standard of quality, of use of substances that could be dangerous for the people, all the solvent and anything, in order to be able to offer a product with the same performance as before, but without using all these substances or limiting at maximum this. We have always had our product that was certified as a product that is compliant with all these standards. But then the next step was, no, it's not enough for us. We have to involve over all the manufacturing system, all the supply chain, in order to have everybody on board with this goal. And that's thanks to this specific protocol, implementing this system, controlling the supply chain, and having everybody committed with this vision, that we were able, or now we are able, to offer a solution that is probably on the market for our specific product, one of the greener and one with the less impact on the sustainable point of view, because at the end the question was how sustainability is affected by responsible manufacturing. So we really believe that we are part of a system. We can't do this alone. We need the help of all the supply chain. We are promoting this specific vision at a global level with all our partners. And we believe that if we want to go toward this direction, we really need to do our work together and not just a single work of a single company. That's the vision we have, and that's how we are approaching or facing this specific subject.
Yes, thank you, Andrea. Every partner from the house by Dilo and his one laboratory in Milano have this vision, this approach for really go in one sustainable, one responsible direction. The next speaker is Guy Shirazi, Director, Product Manager, Design Business Unity from Stratasys 3D Printing Technology, promoting environmental conscious enhancing its production efficiency. Please.
Thank you very much, Loreto. I would like to use this opportunity, first of all, to thank you for letting us speaking here. And more than that, the great collaboration between Dylon and Stratasys in the last 3 years, bringing this vision of 3D printing into this fashion world. So thank you again. And you know, Stratasys is a pioneer 30 years ago in the 3D printing. And before I was born, Stratasys was started with the 3D printing, with the vision of responsible manufacturing. With 3D printing, you are printing only the materials that have been used. You don't have waste. You produce the product right away when you need to use it. So this is the whole mindset and the whole philosophy around the 3D printing. You are producing the product very close to the end customer. You don't need to do the entire transportation all over the world. You don't order in China and you ship it to US. You print it very close to the end use point. We saw it greatly in the corona environment, where hospitals and car manufacturing were producing the spare parts of machines in the hospital, right in the hospital. Think about how great impact we do to the environment and responsibility in these industries. So as I say, Stratasys started 30 years ago. We are pioneer in manufacturing in the automotive industry, in the spaceship, in the aerospace, in healthcare, in dental. I can say that more than 50% of the liners that kids have today are being 3D printed very close to the end user. So we want to bring this vision together with Loreto into the fashion market. And we had luck now that the technology has been matured that we can put it into the fashion industry. I think it's a great opportunity to export the 3D printing into this market, and we invite you all to be our partner to make this revolution. So thanks a lot.
Thank you, Guy. And now I introduce Coloril, very particular application, and in specific, Henrik Linder, Vice President Marketing and Communication. And he speak about the sustainable and creative embroidery, the next generation of responsible embroidery technology.
Thank you, Loreto. I also like to express the gratitude for having us here and allowing me the opportunity to talk to you about sustainable embroideries. And to loop back to Loreto's original question for today's talk and panel discussion, the answer is quite simple. Of course it does. So responsible manufacturing has an extreme importance for sustainability as such. And I will elaborate a little bit on why we from Coloril believe that that's the case. So the DNA of our company is basically sustainability and sustainable decoration, and specifically sustainable embroideries. So if you envision a traditional embroidery manufacturer, you are in most cases utilizing a standard polyester thread. You have 100 or even thousands of different colors in thread stock, which means that you in many cases have a lot of waste because you have to throw them away after best before date. And it also means that you have a lot of transportation of threads back and forth. We have developed a sustainable embroidery technology that allows you to instantly dye the thread while you're embroidering. So it means that we are pretty much a hybrid technology between inkjetting or sublimation and embroidery, with the sustainable benefits that I talked to our manufacturers and producers and brands about, being that we use 100% recyclable polyester. You have no thread waste, and you have no wastewater. So traditionally, batch dyed color and threads is done with a rather large wastewater impact. So when I talk to our clients, in many cases, I talk on sustainability from a what, how, where, and of course a when perspective. The what being to minimize the depletion of material and resources, and in our case then sustainable thread and minimum use of ink, which is a water-based ink that we use. And secondly, the how, of course there are, like Guy mentioned, there's a lot of different sustainable production methods today. And also with our technology, like Guy mentioned on the 3D printing, we bring these responsible and sustainable manufacturing method to the place of decoration. In our case, the thread is dyed on spot, so it minimizes unnecessary waste and unnecessary use of resources. And then in many cases, when I talk sustainability, a final word is, I talk about the when, and the when is now. This is the time that we all start to become more sustainable by taking one step at a time in finding new production methods that supports the sustainability agenda of us as manufacturers and brand owners and producers. Thank you, Loreto.
Thank you very much, Henrik. Very interesting intervention. Now, for Planet Life Economy Foundation, I introduce Paolo Ricotti. Paolo Ricotti is founder of PLEF. It's very important for me, this contribution, because Paolo have the vision about the sustainable approach. And I think this contribution will help all for understand really where is the point and when we have to go. Please, Paolo.
Yes, thank you. Well, actually, my experience was managing a corporate multinational company. And at that time, I saw that sustainability was a really important issue, because if the company culture do not change from the actual or current situation, or we will not have any future. That is why 18 years ago, I founded Planet Life Economy Foundation in order to study how to do it. And that is why I'm here. And that is why we work with Loreto. The issue is simple. No one at the moment can say we are sustainable. Sustainability is a process, as somebody has already said. We will achieve in 30 years, not in 1 year. So no one can say is at this moment sustainable. And that is why we have not to be unfair with this concept, but actually we should try to love it, to adapt our lifestyle to life this concept within our own habit, and then try to put our experience within the company. Each one has to contribute to the development of the sustainability issue or culture within the company. And that is why I'm saying that technologies or circular process are important, of course, within the organization of a company, but they are not the point of saying that this is sustainability. In order to achieve sustainability, you have to change the company culture, working on internal and external practices that the company has already seen. And that is why you have to reposition your organization, to review your competitive edge or competitive advantages, and to reorient all any activity of your people, of working people, in a sustainable ambience. For instance, you have to train all the human resources of your people, not only the technological one, to this concept of evolving style and habits of all the world. That is why you have to work on finance, for instance, understanding that the value of the company is not anymore based on turnover or profit, but is related on how these issues of what we call key performance indicators are working on the intangible side of the value of the company. And this intangible value that are actually contributed to the value of the company are to be seen in any part of your activity. For instance, as the commercial side, marketing side, you have to care very carefully about the consumer relation, the brand reputation, the brand connotation. These are all elements that are part of the full activity of the company, apart from the technological evolvement. But this is not enough. You have to look at what is, for instance, the relationship with your territory. Each company should have a superior goal. Well, okay, superior goal. Sorry, my English is not so perfect. That has to provide employment in the territory in which it operates, as well as try to increase the wellness of the whole community. But you have to care, be patient and carefully on the relationship with your stakeholders. Already was mentioned the supply chain management. Of course, yes. Your suppliers to be totally sustainable, possibly locally, and recognize a good margin. Otherwise, you are not sustainable. You cannot be sustainable, and so on. So, as you can see, and now I'm going to finish, evidently, you have to make sustainability as an ambition, a behavior that is a very strong sex appeal to everybody of your organization. And doing that, you will be sure that in time, with the right management and the right vision, you will achieve full sustainability for your company and for your life and for your world. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Paolo. I want to sensibilize because with the house, we organize the round table around this very important question. Argument. Now, the next speaker is Alexander Zhao, CEO of La La Land. He is from Los Angeles, USA, and he give us the about one vision about the technological manufacturing from California.
How responsible manufacturer has its own value in sustainability? That is the questions that the panel asked me, Alexander Zhar, CEO of La La Land Production and Design in Los Angeles, California. We are a manufacturer of shoes and handbags here in LA, and we have been doing this for the last 20 years. In recent years, we have seen that sustainability, it is being a major factor in whole global scene. not only because of the trend of the sustainability, but actually the effect that we are seeing firsthand here in California in global warming and mounting amount of the used product that it is going to the landfill, and many, many other things that makes every human think about that, how we can help to be more sustainable and prolong the life of this beautiful earth that there is given to us. We at Lala Land, we have been starting to think about the how can we as a factory impact this situation. So we started to implement several factors in here. One, being more aware of the time that we have the machines, for instance, on when it is not necessarily needed, we should be able to turn them off and save some energy. Second, how we can use the some kind of the product and the glue or other type of the material that we use daily in our manufacturing, that it is more sustainable and has more a longevity without impacting the environment. We also partnered with a City of Los Angeles Sanitation Department to understand firsthand what are their problems. What is the issue at their hand and what they are struggling with to handle, and work it backward to see that how we can help a designer that come to our facility that want to start to make it something sustainable and have a limited resources, starting to think about the, what is the impact and working it backward. So we are launching a campaign and a competition for the some designer out of LA to come up with a product, in particular footwear, that we can have the full 360 degrees recycling effect in the production, from using the existing non-virgin but or many limited virgin material into the production, and using a gluing procedure that allow us that after the life of the shoe, it is completed very easily, dismantle this outsole from the upper material, grind the upper material and turn it to the another filament that we will be able to reweave and re-knit for the uppers. The outsoles can be grinded and added another PU coating in it and be able to use it as a compounded the outsole, and giving a lifetime membership to the clients that they can send back their product to us, that we will be able to change their upper for them, put a new upper for them, but yet those material, it is not going to be wasted, and it's not going to finish in landfill, but it's get 360 degree recycling. In addition to that, we are trying to be a source for a lot of the local designers, and providing them with the materials, with the products that are more sustainable, that they can achieve their own design and goal in much better and kinder to the environment as they can. However, we are not perfect. We are not addressing 100% all the issues that it is on hand. However, we are doing our best, and our goal it is to get into that 100%. We also thinking about that, how we're going to be able to make our own factory with a very big, large footprint of the 30,000 square feet, which is around 3,000 square meter roof, to convert that roof to the solar energy gathering station, that we can just make our whole entire factory green factory. These are all not good feeling, but also in the down to the long term, it will have a opportunity for us to be able to reduce our cost of the manufacturing, make a manufacturing a lot more easier to be done in any location that one wants to build a factory, and setting up more and more procedure that can be implemented in the future manufacturing. The question of the sustainability, question of the recycling, it is very, very, very complex, and it is not only one aspect of it from the material, it is human angle of it as well. What is the sustainable? Sustainability is to create more of the global to local, making the production domestically and where the final consumers are, in order to be able to eliminate the carbon footprints that we are impacting. More of the customization and a repurposing. For instance, right now, currently, we are working with two groups, the Karen groups and the LVMH group as well, to find a way that how we can use their excess material or the used product that they have in the market.
Is blocked? Okay. Okay, in any case, thank you, Alexander. And the last guest, important guest and speaker, Cavalier Giancarlo Dani, from the chairman of Gruppo Dani, and speak about technology and circular process in the leather. Prego.
And I will be translating for Mr. Dani.
Sì, che io purtroppo chiedo perdono, ma parlerò in italiano e sarò coadiuvato da una traduzione.
Please accept my apologies. I will be speaking in Italian and have it translated.
Allora, in maniera immeritata devo in un certo qual modo rappresentare i conciatori, i produttori di pelle italiani, di cui faccio parte, sono un espositore e vengo indubbiamente a dare il mio contributo a quello che è una parola così importante, la sostenibilità. Oggi la sostenibilità è una parola anche abusata e vuol dire molto, moltissimo. E indubbiamente andrò ad elencare quello che sta facendo il settore conciario, la mia azienda, ma molte altre aziende, essendo noi italiani, indubbiamente anche apripista nel mondo come tecnologia, come versatilità, come capacità di produrre un prodotto affascinante come la pelle.
Okay, so it's such an honor for me to be representing the tanning industry right now, and yeah, I'm proud to be talking, you know, on behalf of all tanners, all leather makers, and of course, sustainability is such an important topic for us nowadays, which is developed both in terms of technology and on the process that we can put in place towards sustainability. Please.
Allora partiamo un attimo prima di tutto a dire che questo prodotto affascinante che è la pelle deriva dalla macellazione degli animali che a mio avviso nella mia azienda, ma per moltissime aziende, sono animali che sono macellati per la produzione di carne e per l'alimentazione umana, per cui è un punto molto forte questo che voglio logicamente portare avanti e far capire alla comunità e agli utilizzatori delle pelli che indubbiamente non uccidiamo l'animale per le pelli, ma anzi siamo di per sé degli smaltitori, perché è un sottoprodotto, sono un scarto della macellazione che noi recuperiamo e poi intelligentemente andiamo a trasformare.
Yeah, so first of all, I'd like to state clearly, as most of you should, might know, the appealing material, the leather, is it's coming from a byproduct of a different industry, namely the food industry, of course. For most of the leathers, they're coming from the food supply chain. So in our case, specifically of bovine, we're talking of bovine leather. So first of all, we would like to state clearly that no bovine is killed for leather. And it's actually a noble example of giving value to a byproduct of a different industry that has its own demand and production.
Pertanto sostenibilità vuol dire partire anche dall'allevamento, dalla macellazione e in primis di rispettare quello che è il benessere animale. È una cosa importantissima anche perché gli animalisti logicamente battono molto questo, questo tasto, e credo che sia corretto, insomma, che l'animale viva e possa anche essere macellato in maniera, diciamo così, rispettoso anche di questo essere.
And this is why we think, you know, that the first pillar of sustainability in our field comes from animal welfare. So we truly believe that the animals should be carry on a, you know, a life that it's according to the well-being standards until, you know, the slaughtering operation, that all of its life cycle is carried out according to the legislation and to animal welfare philosophy.
Pertanto la continuazione del discorso è questa: l'attenzione che pone il conciatore italiano, il conciatore indubbiamente rispettoso e anche, come dire, sensibile a dare sempre di più ogni giorno la possibilità di tradurre la produzione della pelle in un ambiente che sia salubre, in un ambiente che sia rispettoso di chi ci lavora dentro, del benessere anche dei lavoratori, indubbiamente, oltre che quello animale, e di utilizzare i prodotti, l'acqua e i prodotti chimici necessari per la conservazione e la concia di queste pelli in misura sempre più centellinata, sempre più mirata a essere usata solo, esclusivamente nel rispetto di quello che è l'utilizzo del prodotto indubbiamente riconosciuto dal REACH, ma eliminando tutti quei prodotti che magari riconosciuti ma che potrebbero essere indesiderati. Ecco, in sostanza parto da un presupposto anche del sale. Il sale che noi lo usiamo anche in cucina per salare la nostra pasta asciutta, noi lo usiamo in misura sempre minore, ma per la conservazione delle pelli, una volta macellate venivano salate, e questo utilizzo del sale indubbiamente sta venendo sempre meno per l'avvicinamento tra noi aziende conciarie con l'azienda di macellazione.
Ok, I'll try to summarize because it was long. Okay, so the first of all, one of the pillars is social responsibility along with environmental. So when we talk about sustainability, it's important to specify that it also means offering well-being and safety in the workplace, first of all. So from a social point of view, both in terms of the human resources working at the plant as well as the local community, of course. Then, of course, it's important to consider sustainability from an environmental point of view, and it is translated in the least possible use of resources, so very efficient use of the resources. And for the example, the topic of salt, which is particularly important in leather making because it's used to cure, to preserve the fresh hides, you know, after the slaughtering operation, before starting with tanning, opting for the possibility to work directly the fresh hides, avoiding the use of salt is an example of how you can, you know, diminish the use of resources and be more responsible environmentally speaking.
Ecco, pertanto l'impegno è quello della depurazione dell'acqua, che è molto importante, e stiamo facendo scuola anche al mondo di come depurare in maniera attenta totalmente quella che è l'acqua utilizzata per i processi, limitarne l'uso. Per cui stiamo producendo questo prodotto naturale che la natura appunto ci regala, ed è, ritengo, poi quello che volevo dire in definitiva, la vera economia circolare. Noi prendiamo un prodotto scartato appunto o di scarto dell'alimentazione e ne facciamo un prodotto che va utilizzato in maniera anche, direi, importante in tutti quelli che sono i manufatti in pelle che conosciamo e che fanno di per sé un vestito ai nostri prodotti di grande, grande eccellenza.
Another important topic in sustainability is the use of water, both in terms of the quantity of water that you use for the operation as well as the quality of the wastewaters. And this is another example of why, you know, avoiding to use salt or reducing the use of chemicals as much as possible is important, both in the use of the quantity of water and the quality of water, as well as the fact that leather really represents a perfect example of circular economy. So by taking from nature a natural material, and you know, providing a material that it's appealing, durable, and gives shapes to a lot of daily objects that we can use in our everyday.
Concludendo, in sostanza, noi stiamo tentando una ricerca e sviluppo molto approfondito anche con quelle che sono i prodotti biologici anche che indubbiamente ci accompagnano per conciare la pelle nel migliore modo biologico possibile, per cui le biotecnologie stanno entrando a piedi pari anche nelle nostre aziende.
And all of these very efficient process, of course, needs to be matched with the search for products and to 10 leather that are organic and bio-based. So of course, our R&D efforts are also investigating towards this type of materials, bio-based and organic.
Allora, questo prodotto eccezionale, visto da me che io ne sono innamorato, sono di seconda generazione. L'ho toccato con mano tutti i giorni e veramente è come se mi fossi fatto una, come dire, una dose di pelle. È un mondo affascinante e credo che molti lo stanno come dire, anche boicottando confrontandolo con qualche prodotto sintetico. Ecco, io vorrei dire, teniamo lontano questo bellissimo prodotto naturale con quello che è il prodotto sintetico, che indubbiamente ha la sua valenza, ha la sua importanza, ma è come se volessimo confrontare la vera seta con il nylon. Magari a io che sono profano mi sembrano la stessa cosa, ma insomma dobbiamo invece essere rispettosi della valenza di quelli che sono dei prodotti di eccellenza. Per cui io rispetto tanti prodotti che vengono utilizzati al posto della pelle, ma non andiamo a demonizzarla. Siamo qui per renderla sempre più prodotto circolare, come dicevamo, e per poterlo dare eventualmente, totalmente, ritornarlo all'agricoltura, perché essendo un prodotto sostanzialmente lentamente biodegradabile. Ecco, per cui
I might be biased, my judgment might be biased because I'm truly in love with leather, but I'm a second generation tanner, so I really grew up looking and touching at leather, so I'm really in love with this material. And I think that this very fascinating material should not be compared with alternative solution based, you know, on synthetic artificial material. So, I mean, in terms of the beauty, of the charm that this material has, it should not be compared, in my opinion, to, you know, artificial, like PU-coated synthetic material. It should be regarded as a specific material on its own. And our job is that of making it as sustainable as possible, as much sustainable as possible by doing... Please.
Ecco, per cui grazie di avermi ascoltato. Scusatemi appunto di questa magari disfunzione, ma ahimè lavoro sulla pelle, ma non ho studiato molto, ho fatto le scuole piccole basse io. Comunque no, perdonatemi. Amate la pelle, siate ambasciatori che la pelle è un prodotto insostituibile e grazie di essere in casa nostra e di dire che il conciatore italiano è un conciatore sicuramente molto votato a quella che sarà questa parolona della sostenibilità. Faremo del nostro meglio. Grazie.
Thank you. Thank you so much for listening. Sorry for having to translate, but I was very happy to have the chance to speak with you. And let's all work together to keep the name of leather, you know, as a premium material and make it as sustainable as possible. Thank you all.
Thank you very much, Cavalier Danik, and thank you very much to the speakers. Thank you very much the guest for the attention. And I invite to continue to follow a new point of material.